The Gulf of Mexico was on fire. Here's how this happened. At 5:15 a.m. on July 2nd, 2021, the eye of fire was spotted. An underwater gas pipeline burst in the Gulf of Mexico. The pipeline is owned by Pemex, the Mexican state-owned oil company. The underwater pipeline connects to a platform in the Ku-Maloob-Zaap oil field. This offshore oil field accounts for about 40% of Pemex's oil production. In this offshore oil field, one of the main ways to recover oil from the seabed is injecting natural gas and nitrogen. Being the flammable one, experts suspect that natural gas was in the pipeline that burst. According to statements from Pemex, the facilities were affected by electrical storms and heavy rains, which is why the fire happened. Using a combination of water and nitrogen, the fire was extinguished within 5 hours. At this time, the effect on marine biodiversity and the environment is unknown, although Pemex states that there is no environmental damage. This claim is highly suspicious, which is why groups such as Greenpeace have requested Pemex to conduct an environmental assessment of the damage done by the fire. An interesting point is that if the gas was not ignited and the fire did not happen, it would have taken Pemex a much longer time to discover the gas leak from the underwater pipeline. This pipeline fire is not the first accident caused by Pemex. This company has a long history of accidents. Between 1984 to 2019, Pemex has directly been responsible for over 600 deaths, mainly due to pipeline explosions in Mexico. It is also the seventh most polluting company in terms of carbon emissions. Despite being the most indebted oil company in the world, the Mexican government continues to support Pemex because nearly a third of all tax revenue of the government comes from this company. Mexico aims to be energy independent and seeks to cut reliance on foreign energy, which is why companies like Pemex continue to succeed. Seeking self-sufficiency in terms of energy production is an admirable goal. However, non-renewable sources such as oil and gas are not the answer. We need to move towards renewable sources and clean energy sources for a future that is livable for coming generations. There are many topics to uncover in this incident. However, I will be creating more videos on similar topics, so I hope you enjoyed this one. If you like this video, please consider subscribing for more videos on environmental topics. Thank you so much for watching.